Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be doing a team building guide for the Universe Survival Saga. So essentially this is what we're doing, all right? Because I'm over here on the wiki. So shout out to the DBZ wiki, the Dokkan Battle wiki. Go ahead, check it out. You can create an account and join them over here. Also shout out to dbz.space/DokkanBattleBuilder.com. Go ahead, check it out. You create accounts there as well if you would like to. Now, there's a lot of units that are available on the JP side. I will not be going over all of them in this video. As I told you in the last video when I did the Kale, Kefla, and Khalifla building guide in terms of their new Dokkanings. So, for this video, we have a bunch of cards, including the new Ultra Instinct Goku. So, the Ultra Instinct Goku is new. I haven't done a review on him. We have the Jiren, Android 18, the new Dokkan Awakens for the two Godkus, and the Goku Blue. Plus, we still have the event that I haven't gone over. In this video, we're going to focus on the Universe Survival Saga, which includes the Blue Goku, the Jiren, and Android 18. Now, I will be doing the other God Goku, or the Godku card, this Goku Blue, and the Ultra Instinct Goku. None of them are currently available on DokkanBattleBuilder.com, so once they are available, I will go ahead and do reviews of them. Just for you guys, if you want to know, all they really do is they get a better passive skill, better leader skill, and they all get Fierce Battle added to them. Nothing else really changes. Obviously, that's usually what happens when you get a Dokkan Awakening on cards. But I still want to wait for them to be available on Dokkan Battle Builder for team building. But because we know that they're going to be available, I do feature at least the Goku Blue, or the Godku, the Agility Godku in this team building guide, because he is part of the Universe Survival Saga. This Godku is not part of that. Without further ado, though, let's go ahead and jump into it. First off, really quick to the banner, we have the new Ultra Instinct banner with this Jiren. It looks like Jiren doesn't get a Dokkan Awakening at this time, but he looks like he will at some point in the future. Banner's not that bad, honestly. You have Revive Frieza, you have Kale, you have Khalifla, Ultra Instinct Goku, you have Kefla, you have Jiren. So honestly, I mean, I'm not a really big fan of 18, though she will come in handy, as I will show you on some of the team building guides. She's not a horrible unit. She's definitely going to be good for more of support for certain units. But outside of that, this is a really good banner, and honestly, I know it's not a guaranteed SSR, but if you guys are looking for Dokkan Fest exclusive, this is a really good banner for you to consider, just because even if you don't get a Dokkan Fest exclusive, if you get a featured SSR, none of them are bad. But alright, let's go ahead and jump into it. We're going to go over the Android 18 first, because she's not really too anticipated, plus it's going to be a really quick team building with her. First thing is her title, A Sure Thing, Android 18, Leader Ability, Tech Type Key plus 2, HP Attack and Defense plus 50%, Super Attack Destructo Disc causes supreme damage to the enemy, raises defense by 30% for 6 turns. That's going to be really good for blocking after a while. Her passive skill, Feelings for Her Family, Attack and Defense plus 50%, changes Physical Key to Tech Key, so she is Key or Manipulator, and it's type to type, which I love, that's my favorite kind. Additional attack plus 12% per Rainbow Key Orb obtained. So that's not bad. I mean, I don't expect her to get a lot of attack anyway. It looks like she's just there to be a support unit for some units when she does the key orb manipulation. Her link skills are Android Assault, Twin Terrors, The Innocence, Battlefield Diva, Infinite Energy, and Tournament of Power. Tournament of Power is key plus 3, by the way. That's a really good link skill for this team. Obviously, she's part of the Universe Survival Saga. And her base stats are HP of 8385, attack of 7740, and defense of 4952. She does have a really high defense. If you guys happen to want to put dupe system into her, her max HP is going to be 11385, attack of 10740, and defense of 7982. And notably, her defense almost goes up to 10,000 if you fully dupe her out. Now, personally, I would never do that to her, because she's not really that useful of a unit, in my opinion, at least in terms of damage output. But if you're looking, I would recommend, if you're going to do a dupe system, to the bottom left path, just to increase her defense up a lot more. That way she's, you know, tanking a lot better, especially if you have her on primary rotation. She's a 12 key multiplier of 135%. Now, in terms of who she links well with, switching over here real quick, she really doesn't link that well with anyone. As always with the androids, they only really link well with each other, and unfortunately we don't have a lot of a selection. All these guys actually that are here, they're all extreme, so you can't run her on an actual super team with anyone. I mean, I guess you can with the other 17, but it's still not going to come in handy too much. Overall, not horrible. She does link with 3 key with the LR android, so that's not horrible. 4 key and, 3 links, 4 key, 10% attack buff. Extreme Android 17 is 10%, 1,000 defense up, and 4 key. The same thing with this Android 17 over here, 4 key, 10% up, defense 1,000 up, and then the TUR version of the LR Androids, if you haven't been able to do it yet, it's 4 key and 10% up. Overall, not really that great in terms of best linking buddies, but you know what, she is there, she's available to link with some other guys. You can go over here, I guess, and you could throw the SSRs for 3 or above, and you see a lot more she's available. If you're including SSRs, I guess we could pump that up to 4 now. And as you see, there's all these other 18s that she is available to link with. Again, it's just Androids. That's all she really links very well with. I'm sorry for how this cuts in and out. It's just the way that the website's built, so... but yeah, all like 17s, like the Super 17s, the Androids, all that stuff. So you can go ahead and link her up with any of the Androids if you really want to. Going over here to a Monotech team, she's really bad. She only links well with this other MIR-17, the Super version. And now he is a Super version, so that's good. She shares 4 link skills with him. Key plus 2. Let's see. What is it? Key plus 2, defense 1,000 up. Key plus 2, key plus 3. So there's a lot of key there and a defense buff. No attack buffs, unfortunately. And with the Arale, so for those of you who were able to pull the Technique Arale, she gets, 10% up and 2 key, so I mean, not really that great. But hey, you know what, that's what it is. She's not really meant for being on a main rotation, which I'm going to show you guys in a little bit after I go over a full Universe Survival Saga team building guide, but that's what she's available for. And next we're going to go over the Explosive Battle Urge Super Saiyan God Goku. Now again, he's going to be in this video specifically because he's part of both Realm of Gods and Universe Survival Saga, so you will see him in both videos, though my review of him is going to be specifically in this video. So his leader ability is all types key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 40%, super attack limit breaker Kamehameha, raises attack and causes supreme damage to the enemy, his passive skill Legendary Presence, attack and defense plus 80% when performing a super attack, so that's not horrible. Just remember, that's when he's performing a super attack, not before it. So if he's getting attacked beforehand, like if he's in the first slot, he's not going to get that defensive boost. It's after he launches a super attack. Link skills are Godly Power, Shocking Speed, Super Saiyan, Over in a Flash, Kamehameha, Warrior Gods, and Fierce Battle. He has some really good link skills, I'm not going to lie to you there. Categories are Realm of Gods and Universe Survival Saga. He has max base stats of HP of 8,820, attack of 8,089, and defense of 5,438. Another really high defense. Max base dupe system is going to be HP of 10,820, attack of 10,089, and defense of 7,448. And if you guys happen to want to rainbow him, which I don't really think they would have a real reason to, but he does have a really good defensive stat, so maybe you would if you want to run him on a primary team, or if you just like Goku cards. HP of 13,420, attack of 13,089, and defense of 10,838. Not going to lie to you, he's not going to be that bad. 12 key multiplier is an odd 142%. His raises attack is a 30% boost. And obviously, as I've said to you guys in multiple videos before, the physical Goku card can increase his super attack. So you can go ahead and go through that grind if you want to. That's the White Hot Face Off Super Saiyan Goku will Dokken Awaken into that Goku card, which you'll have to Z Awaken to an Ultra Rare and Ordered Feed into this SSR variant before you Dokken Awaken him. Yes, big process, I know. So we're done with him. We are going to talk about team building with him, but because he's not available, we'll talk about him again in the next video. So when I do the Realm of Gods, that's when I'll do that. So this is the new Jiren, and this is one you are all probably waiting for, the Invincible Myth of Universe 11 and Jiren. Let's see here. Leader ability, Universe Survival Saga category, key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 120%. So to me, it sounds like he's, when he gets a Dokken Awakening, it's going to be key plus 3, HP attack and defense plus 150. Or he does Strength type key plus 2, HP attack and defense plus 40%, which will probably just be buffed to key plus 3, HP attack and defense plus 50%. His super attack power impact immense damage to the enemy and greatly lowers defense. That's really not that bad. His passive skill, Strength is Justice, attack and defense plus 120%, medium chance to stun all enemies. I mean, that medium chance is kind of meh, but whatever, it's cool for a strength unit to actually have that. There's not a lot of strength units that can actually stun. An attack and defense plus 120% with an immense damage modifier, he's nothing to laugh at, especially if you consider he's getting attack and defense before he Dokken Awakens of 120%. That might jump up to 150%. He's going to be a beast. Link skills are Cold Judgment, Shocking Speed, Infighter, Hero of Justice, Tournament of Power, and Godly Power. So he doesn't have the best linking skills, but when you do get the good ones off, he's going to link really well. Category is Realm of Gods and Universe Survival Saga, so you will see him again. And max stats are going to be HP of 7635. Wow, that's kind of low, actually. Attack of 9170 and defense of 5283. Max stats are going to be HP of 9635, attack of 11170, and defense of 7283. And his max stats, max dupe system stats, are going to be HP of 12635, attack of 14570. That's actually ridiculous. And defense of 9883. So, personally, I think his defense should be buffed, I think his HP should be buffed, I feel like his overall stats should be buffed, but then again, his passive skill makes up for it, so whatever, it's not that horrible. He does have a 12 key multiplier of 150%. Again, he doesn't have a Dokken Awakening right now, so we can't really do anything with it, but he is still a really good leader. Now, in terms of best people to put on a team. This is the all of the units that you could possibly run. At least they're either their TUR variant or the SSR if it's there. If I'm missing anyone, I apologize. I think I grabbed everyone that I could possibly grab. That I believe that's going to be part of it, because not every single character is part of this category as of yet in terms of Dokkan Battle Builder. So these are all the units in game that currently are available. I'm not going to go the close up view just because it's going to be, like, I'll show you, it's going to be off screen if I do this. Actually, it's not that bad, so we'll do this. So as you see over here, we have the two Khaliflas. They don't link together. They can't put you both run on the team, but you could run either one depending on which one you have. They link well with Kale, Kefla. Yeah, the two Keflas that are over here. Well, actually, this is Super Saiyan 2 Kale, so she can actually be run on the team separately. So you have all these guys over here, Kaba. The two Kabas can't be on the same team. So the two Kabas can't be on the same team. The two Khaliflas can't be on the same team. So you're going to have to pick one of these guys, one of these two, and then the rest of these can be on the same team. Obviously, you have the two androids that link very well together. You have your Jiren over here. He links well with links decent with Topo for 3. He links well with Hit. You have the two Friezas, the Golden Angel Frieza, and then you have the other Frieza, the Agility Frieza, which is farmable. They do link for 6 link skills together. You have Bergamo, you have Ultra Instinct Goku. I actually should not have him on here because he actually doesn't have the category, so I'm taking him off. So you actually didn't see him. I had the Strength Godku card there. I thought the Strength Godku card actually was part of this, and he wasn't. So you have the Agility Godku card, you have Urine, and you have Skinny Boo. So you have a lot of units here now. This is just everyone you could actually have on the team. Personally, we're going to go over my team building. In terms of my team building, I took out most of the free-to-play units, and I took out a lot of the units that I don't think should be on this team. Obviously, you're going to have Jiren over here, so Jiren's going to be your primary unit. You're probably also going to have him on rotation because you're probably going to want to run something different off of on your other primary rotation. There's a lot of other units. I mean, if you're just looking for damage output, Jiren and Jiren might be your best bet. I mean, you can throw Jiren on there with Hit if you really want to. Again, like I said, Jiren and Hit do link pretty well together. Let's go over here and see. What do they actually link with? Let me scroll down for you guys so you can actually see them. So they link together with defense up, attack up, and 2 key. So it's not horrible. So if you really want to do that, you can. I'm not going to recommend doing that personally. I think that this setup is probably going to be your best setup right over here. So once the Ultra Instinct Goku and the Godku cards, if you have them Dokkan Waken, they also will share Fierce Battle. But they have 3 current key links, right? The 3 current key links is Kamehameha, God of... Godly Power, which is to attack plus 15% up, and Short-Term Decisive Battle, or Over in a Flash, which is 3 key. So they're going to be getting each other a lot of attack buffs, and they have 3 key, which is awesome. It's phenomenal. Once Jiren gets his Dokkan Awakening, you're never going to not get a super attack. Well, I'm not going to say that, but you only need 3 key to get a super attack off. So that's going to be super useful. Obviously, like I said, Jiren and Topo do link very well together. You have Shocking Speed. You have, what is this? There's another one, Universe. Heroes of Justice for attack plus 25% up. And the Force of Convention Energy, I guess that's Universe Survival Saga, key plus 3. So that's really phenomenal. That's actually a really awesome, awesome setup. Because what is this? Throne of the Powers, key plus 3, right? So these two are going to link together. These two are going to link together. Now, if you want to, you can have Android 18 and Kefla. They are both key orb manipulators. Kefla will change to physical key. And then Android 18 will change physical to technique key. So by the time, but they have to be in this order too. Kefla has to be first, Android 18 has to be second. By that time, Kefla is going to get a lot of ki and a lot of attack buffs because of that. So you are going to have a really good setup there. If by any chance you don't have a Kefla and you have Android 18 and you like Android 18 and you want to run her, you can throw 17 on there. They do share 4 link skills, as I said before. It's going to be a decent team. It's going to be a good setup for you guys, but it's really up to you on how you want to run it. I personally think that that's a really nice setup for you. The Kefla will change. Let me actually bring her up over here on my other screen. Kefla changes intelligence to physical, and remember, she does get attack and defense plus 12% per key orb obtained. So when you have a double key orb manipulation, you're going to have at least half the field, usually half the field, to order her to give that to her. So she's going to have a lot of attack buff. So that's going to come in really handy. The next we also have this Kaba. Kaba isn't horrible. He is not that horrible of a unit. You can go ahead and run him. He does get attack plus 80% when performing a super attack. And for every Universe Survival Saga ally on your team, chance to get a critical hit goes up by 7% up until 49%. So you have a 50% chance, essentially, to get a full crit on him. And that doesn't include if you happen to have the crit fed into him in the dupe system. He's a free-to-play unit. He gets supreme damage, and he gets an attack plus 80%. So he's not horrible. I will be going over him in a different video. That's when I go over the actual event guide. That's when I'll talk about him. So he's good. He's there. He's also going to be good for the Kale and Khalifa. Now, I did do a review of these two cards already. If you guys haven't checked it out, go ahead and check it out. These two are really good units. Personally, these two link very well together, at least in my opinion. Unfortunately, they have no attack buffs that they link together, but they will always get key off. They have, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11. They have 11 key. You will always get a super deck off when these two link together. So you also have Kaba that's here. He links with 5 link skills with Khalifa, which is, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7... 7 key, 8 key actually, because a Golden Warrior, attack plus 10% up. So that's really awesome. And he links well with Kale, so he gets 4 link skills with Kale. He also links well with Kefla as well, so keep that in mind. So he's going to be a good filler unit. If you happen to have Kale, Khalifa, or Kefla, he will be a good filler unit if you only have one of them and you want someone to link well with him. Because he's just really good, because he's free to play, and you can link with any of them. And then the next and last set of people that run together is going to be the free-to-play Frieza and the Golden Frieza. Those two are actually pretty good. They're pretty good linking buddies. I wouldn't recommend... I mean, you can run them if you want to. If you happen to like you like your Revival Frieza. He's not a horrible unit whatsoever. I shouldn't have put him at the bottom. I feel like he should have been one of the primary picks just because he is a Dokkenfest exclusive. And he does a lot of damage. So let's go and take a look really quick at him. So I'm bringing him up over here, this Frieza. You can go on the left-hand side of DokkenBattleBuilder.com. It's just easier because it's actual English translations. His passive skill, though, the agility one, is key plus 3, attack and defense plus 50% for 7 turns. So it's not horrible. He only does extreme damage, but he does lower attack. But he's going to share all those link skills with this Golden Frieza. So if you're looking to do that and you don't have anyone else to throw on there, he'll be a good fill-in character. Outside of that, he really has no one else to link with that well on this team. So you can link these two together if you want to bring your revived Frieza on the team with you. Together, they have 2, 4, 5, 6, 7 key links. And 35% attack buff. So really good setup between the two of them. But anyway, guys, that is all of that. And in terms of Jiren, in terms of his best linking buddies, he doesn't have that many on a mono strength team. He has 2 with Gohan, 2 with Beerus, and 2 with Zamasu. So you have, let me go ahead and translate this to English. So you have Cold Judgment, God Dimension. I'm pretty sure this is Cold Judgment and God Dimension. Or no, this is Shocking Speed and God Dimension. And you have Gohan with Infighter and Shocking Speed. So not horrible, but he's not going to be good for a primary strength team. Overall, he's really going to be his own leader category is going to be the best team and only team you would really want to run him on. Not a bad unit, but a really nice team. You have a lot of good options on this. Unfortunately, most of your options are going to be the newer cards you have to pull on them. Like I said before, though, you can use your free-to-play units. The free-to-play units are not going to hit as hard as their summonable counterparts, but they're going to do just as good. Like I said earlier, you have Super Saiyan 2 Khalifa. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention that Super Saiyan 2 Khalifa, she is free-to-play. You're going to want her off rotation as a support unit because she does really well, actually, when she Dokkan Awakens. From her passive form, her passive skill is Universe Survival Saga category, key plus 2, attack and defense plus 30%. So she's giving everyone attack and defense plus 30%. Sorry, I didn't go over that before. She also has some really good link skills for Kaba, Kale, Khalifa, and Kefla. So that's going to come in handy, real handy for you as well if you're running them on primary rotation. Overall, guys, though, this is a really nice setup. I really like this team. I really like everything that's going on over here. I don't have a lot of these units, but hopefully I do. I have the Universe 6 guys. So I don't have this guy in terms of my global account. So when this comes to global, I'll be happy. But anyway, guys, that's it. That's for the team building guide. I hope that was helpful and informative for you. That's a lot of fun. This is definitely a really good team to run, especially if you have the newer units. And if you guys are rerollers, you shouldn't have any issues. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today, and I'll catch you all later. Peace.